Are you suffering from infertility and considering the use of fertility supplements to help you on your infertility journey? If so, you need to watch this episode of Infertility TV. I will tell you everything you need to know about fertility supplements. First, this is a huge industry. Every year, couples in the USA spend over $400 million on fertility supplements. By comparison, $379 million was spent last year on Tylenol. Fertility supplements are big, big business. Before you purchase a fertility supplement, you should know the answers to a few very important questions. Are fertility supplements really natural? The answer is easy. No. Fertility supplements are not in any way natural. Let's take the example of a common fertility supplement called chasteberry. The chaste tree is a small shrub native to European, Mediterranean, and Central Asian countries. In order to go from this to this, the fruits must be dried, treated with various chemicals, extracted in filtering columns, supplemented with other chemicals and preservatives, and encapsulated. The fruit of the chaste tree contains three different classes of chemicals: iridoid glycosides, flavonoids, and diterpenoids. The levels of these chemicals will be altered based on the industrial processing that occurs. It may start out as something natural, but the end product is far removed from that. What's in these supplements? A recent survey of 39 fertility supplements found that they contained a total of 94 different ingredients. These ingredients were manufactured by 27 different companies. Manufacturers are supposed to accurately list those ingredients and their amounts, but there's no regulatory agency that makes sure that labels match what's in the bottles. You risk getting less, or sometimes more, of the listed ingredients. All of the ingredients may not even be listed. That brings us to the most important question. Do fertility supplements really improve fertility? In the USA, dietary supplements can be legally sold without proof of safety and without any proof of effectiveness. The law does allow manufacturers to make vague health claims, such as that a supplement supports fertility or improves reproductive health. They are prohibited from claiming a product treats a specific medical condition, like infertility, unless they submit results from clinical studies showing a benefit. None of the fertility supplement makers have done so. Let me repeat that. Not one of the manufacturers of fertility supplements have submitted any data to the FDA that they can treat fertility problems, improve pregnancy rates, shorten the time to pregnancy, make it more likely for a woman to ovulate, or any other fertility-related problem. Don't believe me? Recently, a nonprofit consumer watchdog, the Center for Science and the Public Interest, did an exhaustive review of 39 fertility supplements. Not a single manufacturer of any of the 39 products provided any reasonable scientific evidence that its products help women become pregnant. The products' websites were, at best, deceptive and rely on the fact that most people will not look at the studies that they list. When they looked at the supposed evidence, the center found 4 studies cited no increase in pregnancy rates. 4 others didn't look at pregnancy rates. 1 assessed its ingredient using a dose that was 8 times the dose that was actually in the supplement. When they contacted the 39 products manufacturers via email asking for scientific evidence, 11 did not reply, and 16 cited no supportive studies. 4 cited customer reviews as evidence, and 3 cited studies that showed no increase in pregnancy rates. In fact, the center's assessment of fertility supplements was so alarming that they wrote to the Food and Drug Administration and the Federal Trade Commission and asked them to take enforcement action against the manufacturers, who they documented are marketing the supplements as unapproved drugs. Is there any harm? I know what your argument is going to be. Why not try it? I'm not pregnant now, so what's the harm of trying it? Actually, there is a huge potential for fertility supplements to cause harm. There are several ways in which you could be harmed by fertility supplements. Number one, contaminants. Heavy metals such as lead, mercury, arsenic, and cadmium are commonly found in many different types of supplements. In some cases, the plants are grown in areas where the soil is contaminated by heavy metals leaking from nearby factories. In other cases, the contaminants are purposely added for various reasons, such as making the supplement a different color. If your body's soft tissues accumulate too much of these heavy metals, the resulting poisoning can cause serious damage. A large amount of scientific evidence has found that heavy metals actually interfere with fertility, increase the risk of miscarriage, and can cross the placenta to directly poison a fetus or cause problems with fetal development. Number two, drug spiking. For the most part, the ingredients in supplements are ineffective. Manufacturers will therefore add actual prescription drugs. In fact, from 2007 to 2016, the Food and Drug Administration identified 776 supplements that were spiked with pharmaceutical drugs. Some of the drugs found in supplements were ones that were actually removed from the market for safety reasons. These drugs can potentially interfere with fertility, cause miscarriages, or cause birth defects. Number three, drug interactions. People who take more than one type of medication run the risk that the medications might interact with each other and cause a serious problem. The same can occur with supplements. Look at the ingredients of one popular fertility supplement. That is five different chemicals that can interact with each other or other medications you're taking. Number four, organ damage. A number of recent studies have found that even short use of some types of supplements can cause liver or kidney damage. Sometimes the damage is reversible, but sometimes it is not. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. There is no scientific evidence that fertility supplements help fertility. There is evidence that supplements can cause harm to your overall health and may even damage your fertility, cause miscarriages, or harm a fetus. Therefore, not only should you not take fertility supplements, you should write to the FDA and ask them to take enforcement action against these companies. For information about fertility scams, check out this playlist. If you like this video, remember to like this video. If you have an idea for a future episode of Infertility TV, leave it in the comments. Subscribe now. Infertility TV publishes a new episode every week. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.